Memphis players making their way through the tunnel earlier, and the home fans are already fired up to get this game started. A breathtaking view of Memphis, Tennessee as we get ready to go here today. Thanks for joining us here on 2K Sports for NBA basketball. We'll watch the Memphis Grizzlies in this one as they go up against the Oklahoma City Thunder, along with Grant Hill and Brent Berry, and our sideline reporter, Allie LaForce. This is Brian Anderson. Hey, Allie.
Thanks, BA. Well, the NBA's play-in tournament is exciting. It's a way to keep teams in the mix, but it's had its share of critics. Luka Doncic said, quote, "I don't understand it. You play all season to get into the playoffs. Then maybe you lose two in a row and you're out? I don't see the point, guys."
Yeah, Allie, team's definitely motivated to stay in the top six. Good stuff there. Thank you. And let's check out a breakdown looking at some stats for Shai Gilgeous-Alexander.
And his foul shooting has looked a little weaker over the last five games compared to where he was the rest of the season. I know how frustrating that can be, and I'm sure he's eager to turn it around.
And the Oklahoma City starting five. We've got Lugans Dort, also Darius Bazley out there, and it's Giddey and Dugar. And for Memphis, Jackson Jr. and Adams together inside. Desmond Bain is out there with Tyus Jones. And it's Brooks in at the three slot. And Grant, as you watch the league since you retired, what do you think is the biggest change?
Well, you started to see the three-point boom change towards the end of my career. And of course, also, how centers are used is probably the biggest change of them all.
And the Grizzlies start out with the ball. From deep, Bain gets the three ball to go.
And into this game overtime. When Jackson spots his open teammates like this, the offense runs much smoother.
Now here's Gilgeous-Alexander. Robinson Earl. And that one is stopped right through.
Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. Love to see him get up like that.
Brooks outside. Dort with a steal. Pass to Giddey. Robinson Earl. Adams cover.
Did you guys see that? What an insane slam.
Man, you gotta have some hang time to pull that off. Brooks outside. Jackson with three. And again, it's Memphis with a three.
He's consistent from out there, especially when you give him that kind of room.
Knocks it loose. Jones drives in. And he makes it on the layup.
A bit of a perfect start here to this game. He's connected on all three looks.
Here's Giddey. Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander. Clock at six. On the tank. And slam shot by Gilgeous-Alexander.
Well, we've talked so much about Gilgeous-Alexander's athleticism. This is the reason why, on display.
Jones drives in. Perfect night so far. Two for two.
They can't miss. Four for four. Warming up the burner.
And about 2 minutes into the first quarter here. And there's the call on Dylan Brooks. That's his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul. First team foul.
Outside, Gilgeous-Alexander. Over Jones. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
That's his first personal foul.
Gilgeous-Alexander starting to become the face of the Thunder in their rebuild.
Both free throws good from Gilgeous-Alexander. And as you said, Brent, Gilgeous-Alexander is the clear centerpiece for this team.
I think the quiet confidence BA that he has is probably one of the more remarkable aspects of Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. He's going about his business. He's not talking about it. He's showing you what he's capable of doing.
Now here's Gilgeous-Alexander. We saw him with 39 points last game. Now
you're just tuning in, we played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Five on the clock. Fires the three. The Thunder with another miss. Memphis has gone 2-3 from three-point land so far. Another shot. Jackson can't get it to go.
I'm not going to see that very often. Defense in the vicinity, but still, he's not one to blow layups.
Dort's shot is good.
And I think Shai Gilgeous-Alexander knows that this is an assist play in the making. Finds the open man.
Jackson outside. Let's the three fly. The Thunder with the rebound. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule. They lost to the Rockets. And that was a tough loss. One or two breaks go their way, and it's a totally different outcome.
Yeah, really a game that they should not have lost, but sometimes, even when you play your best, it might not be good enough.
Three-pointer Brooks sinks it. What range from downtown. Brooks has got 6 points. I love this approach. Getting him involved early has already paid off.
Well, he's going to just keep going. That's really confidence for him.
Coming onto the floor for the Thunder, Derek Favors. Alexei Pokushevsky.
We've got 1:28 left in the opening quarter. From deep, Bane. It's hauled in by Baisley. For Oklahoma City, they've gotten 5 of 7 shots to fall. Back to Gilgeous-Alexander. Shoots from 14. Misses off the left iron.
It's been neck out of quarter four. The shot has just been unreliable.
Jones, his shot is good. He's got 6.
Well, looking into the gaps of the defense there, he's not going to miss many of those when he gets to that range.
Finished off the break. He still hasn't missed. 4 to start the game. Oklahoma City's gone 1 for 2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter.
Now the question is, do you leave him in? A third foul this early could spell trouble.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Melville's checked in. Memphis on deep. 4-point game.
The deep doesn't seem to be too worried about him from 3-point range, and he shows us why still. I expect him to make one of those.
Second chance shot. And Jackson lays it in.
You don't want to ever give up points on the boards. That's the lesson for the team there. That's a hustle play to save points.
Dort for 3. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Their first chance this season playing the Thunder.
They won the season series last year. And on paper, it looks like they should do it again.
And for the Thunder, they're shooting a solid 50% in the opening quarter. To the middle is Pokuševski. Laid it in with a nice touch off the window.
And you like the balance here. Not just falling in love with the three ball.
From deep, Melton. It's hauled in by Baisley. Baisley's got 4 rebounds now. From deep. Oh, no good on the last second attempt there. The baskets were coming early and often in the first quarter. It's the Grizzlies up by 4. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
Of certain players.
A veteran's understanding of help and positioning, Grant.
Yeah, I love that defensive mind approach. That's why they're a team to be reckoned with.
If you're just joining us, we played through one quarter in this one. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for Memphis.
Well, guys, they are dialed in from long range already. They didn't waste any time getting into a groove out there.
I'm loving the ping-pong action of the ball tonight. A decent number of assists so far.
On the floor for Oklahoma City, getting going in the second. Derek Favors out there with Isaiah Roby. Then it's Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Then there's Maladon, and it's Pokuševski in at the three. And I'm glad we got to see the mobile one block once more. What a play.
You know, you can't ask for any better defense than that. He responded so fast to the shooter, and it stifled him.
So it's the Thunder now. Pass to Roby. Back to Favors. To the paint. Here's Pokuševski. Deflected! Here's Tillman. And here's Jones. Brooks outside. From deep three-point range. Drains it. Now he's 3-for-5. A lot of times, left-handers are trickier to defend. But some say lefties tend to be less ambidextrous than right-handers.
I don't know how those guys play backups in the A, to be honest with you. But really, it's about, throughout the course of the year, there's so few lefties that you're not used to playing them. So you have to make these adjustments to guys, and it's hard to catch up. It might take a quarter or two before you realize this guy's a lefty.
Backing up that last three with another three. The defense has to stop giving them so many clean looks.
Maladon, no good. For Memphis, they've got 2 of 3 shots to go in the second. On the wing, Jones. And again, it's the Grizzlies from deep.
Anderson has great vision as a point forward. Exceptional court awareness.
There's a whistle. That goes on DeAnthony Melton. That's his first foul.
First two.
Approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second. Offensive rebound, Favors. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance at a three-point play.
Oh, 265 pounds of fury. Favors is a handful, and if you foul him, you better really foul him.
That's good from Favors. The Grizzlies have gotten 3 of 4 field goals in the second quarter. On the wing, Brooks, for three, and again, it's the Grizzlies from deep.
A dozen consecutive points off of threes. This defense looks rattled.
Oklahoma City's gone 1 of 2 from downtown here in the second. Pass to Favors. To the inside. Second chance effort. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
The Favors is a quick, athletic big man. He can get to the line, but he continues to work on his ability to convert while there.
Bain, he's checked in for Memphis. Williams has checked in for Oklahoma City.
He wasn't quite as assertive as he needed to be in the first quarter, but now he's taking a more head-on approach and getting himself to the line.
And the basket by Bain.
He just takes advantage of the D in a way that very few players playing today can do.
Pass to Favors. Outside, Williams. And good on the 7-footer.
Good passing to set that up. Teamwork on display.
For Memphis, they've got 5 of their first 6 attempts to fall in the second. And that one's good for Bruce.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. 4 of the last 5 buckets have been threes.
Williams on the wing. 13 feet out. That shot is off. Now Memphis takes it the other way. After this one, they're off to Dallas to take on the Mavericks. It'll be the front end of a 2-game road trip. Bounds, it'll go to the Thunder.
Looks like a simple play, and it turned into a turnover. Can't give away possessions like that.
Jaren Jackson, he's checked in for Tillman. And Oklahoma City with a change here, too. Muscala, he's checked in for Roby. Here's Gilgeous-Alexander to the left wing. Muscala's got space. Oh, he clanks that one off the back iron, and it falls.
Great work collapsing the defense and kicking it out.
For Memphis, they've got 6 of their 7 shots to go in the second quarter.
You look at Gilgeous-Alexander and the way he plays. He has kind of that old man style to him. A lot of crafty moves and fakes in his book. Time and time again, they're creating good looks from close range.
So it's the Grizzlies now. After the basket by Oklahoma City. And almost 4 minutes gone in the second quarter of play. And Muscala with the slam.
And nobody putting out much of an effort to stop him.
Surprising in a close game. A lack of energy on defense.
one side, inspiration, on the other, devastation.
And talking about Gilgeous Alexander, this guy plays like a 10-year vet.
I mean, he has great footwork to get to the paint. He uses those Euro steps and hesitation so well. He reminds me in some ways of a young model.
Kind of like playing in the rec league, little to no defense on that possession, and the easiest three-pointer you can imagine.
Pass to Brooks. There's the three. Man, that bucket makes it 6-for-10 in the contest. Just how awesome is it to watch the best of the best start to dominate in a game. And there's the call on Dylan Brooks. That'll be a second foul of the game.
That's two fouls in as many quarters. He may have to adjust his approach now.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Adams is checked in. Baisley, he's checked in for Oklahoma City. Dort comes in for Maladon. Gilgeous Alexander, a good look. And that one hits the back iron.
I know it's about defending the post and the three-point line these days, but still gotta be active in the mid-range area. And the defense gets away with one. Two teammates connecting right there. Slick feed.
There's the steal. It's 2-on-1. Game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Kept alive. Jackson gets the bucket. And it's a 7-point Memphis lead.
I love the strength shown by Jackson there. Refusing to let the defense have the last word.
And he drops a first.
And give them credit for making a more concerted effort to get to the line this quarter.
Taking two shots.
Free throws good from Gilgeous Alexander.
Well, Gilgeous Alexander, such an intriguing prospect coming out of Kentucky. I can't wait to watch in a new system how it is that he starts to understand and develop further his offensive
play. And what's working here? Each guy is willing to make the next pass.
Here's Williams.
And Williams punches it home. And just a lack of fight right now on the defensive end.
Right? At least on that slam it was. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
You have to credit the aggressiveness offensively, because that's when you make a play when you really need it.
And so it's the Memphis Grizzlies with a 6-point lead at the close of the quarter. Getting lots of great looks, shooting it well. That's why they're up. Back after this.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, folks. Ernie Johnson here with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. It's the NBA on 2K Sports, and let's talk the first half. For the Grizzlies, the first quarter was pretty even. And in that period, the most they trailed by was 3. Well, for the Grizzlies, Kenny, what's your view?
Well, they were lighting it up from 3. That was the difference in the first half. They did a good job of running off screen, spotting up, and getting rid of the ball quickly. And their shot selection, solid.
And now, Shaq, let's get your opinion on Oklahoma City.
It's the work they've done in the paint that's impressed me. A lot of good points that
come
from the inside.
They need to keep their production when the post coming in the second.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks. Thanks for joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
Second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Look at Dylan Brooks. What a contribution.
I like how they control the tempo and play to his strengths.
Yeah, this is showing that they're not going to play at anybody else's pace but their own.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Jackson Jr. and Adams together inside. Tyus Jones is out there with Desmond Bane. And it's Brooks in at the 3. The small forward. That's the lineup out there for the Grizzlies. Now here's Jones. Tightly guarded. Can't hit that one.
I think he rushed that one just a little bit, thinking the defense was going to get close. They weren't.
Here's Giddey. Oh, Adams with the block.
Well, Steven Adams is very much capable of anchoring the defense right there. Great spot to get the block.
Talk about two there.
You've got to love his unselfishness. And you know his coach does as well.
Well, not just coach, but you can see it in the teammates, the way that they look at him. They appreciate it when he shares the ball like that. Yeah, starting the half here, 1-for-5, and the offense might need an ironing out.
Hey. Look at that mobile one block defensive performance.
Yeah, what a play. I mean, that'll have the offense thinking twice about taking shots in his presence.
And for those tuning in, we're about a minute into this second half.
The third quarter has not started well, just 1-for-4.
Dort's shot is good.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. Yeah, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Outside Jones. Pass to Brooks. The three from Bane. On target for Bane. Bane's got 10.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim.
Gilgeous Alexander learning this offensive system and learning it well.
Bane into the lane. And that one goes. He's now recorded his fifth bucket in 8 tries.
D has been just completely helpless and turned around. He's so dangerous when he's in this kind of rhythm.
Well, if you're a fan of this team, you have to be happy with the way Dort's game has grown.
You can count on Dort to continue to improve. After his rookie year, he has a great trajectory for his career.
Time called here. The Grizzlies decide to talk it over.
This team had a huge belief in Darius Bazley and the potential.
And some changes here for the Grizzlies. Mark is checked in for Jackson. Conchar comes in for Bane. And it's Melton in for Jones. And also a switch here for Oklahoma City. Pokashevsky's checked in for Dort. Bazley, his breakout came in the Orlando bubble.
Down there and made the most of his chances. I think that's grown his confidence.
Yeah, that one goes.
When it's this close, every bucket matters. You need good looks.
And Melton, here we go. And he goes in for the dunk.
He sends it home.
I think he's rubbing it in a little bit here. Hanging up there like that. Just under 2.5 minutes into this third quarter now. Gilgeous Alexander. He's got 13.
Capable of running the offense, and now a new one for Gilgeous Alexander.
Memphis leading. Melton on the wing. Gilgeous Alexander defending.
Darius Bazley. That's his first personal foul.
And he knocks down the first one. And the Thunder making a change here. Favors has checked in. Both shots good from the strike. Oklahoma City has gone 1-for-2 from outside the arc in this third quarter. Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Good setup. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
Gilgeous Alexander becoming more and more comfortable where he can score on the floor.
We've got 1:55 left in the third quarter here. And that one's good for Brooks. This defense just can't stay connected to shooters. There's a minute 45 left in the third quarter. We got a piece of it. They get it back. First one falls.
At the line for the Thunder. Darius Bazley. Two shots.
And so he hits both.
And Darius Bazley with an interesting path to the NBA. He skipped college in 2019. His own private workouts to prepare for the league.
Conchar, good.
Textbook bounce pass there, perfectly timed.
The Thunder have got 7 of 12 shots to drop in the third.
You know, Grant, with Bazley's pass to the league,
initially wanted to go to his G League, but backed out of that.
Yeah, a lot of twists and turns on his journey. One of more players have bypassed college. Bazley took a risk, and it seems to have paid off for him.
Anderson's checked in for Memphis. Here's Conchar, and it's Giddy with a rebound.
Well, that's how to protect the rim without fouling. Force him into an awkward release with a bit of an adjustment on the layup.
And here's Adams, looking for his first basket still in this one. Here's Conchar. They get the rebound. All right, guys, bring that here to the hustle stat for the Grizzlies.
Oh, their defense has been outstanding. Closing out on shots and blocking quite a few as well.
A significant difference here has been the number of points off turnovers that they've got.
Here's Favors. The Grizzlies making their last shot. And the shot goes down.
Where was the D on that one? Just too easy.
Adams goes in. And slammed in by
Adams. You gotta close up any lane to the basket, because if you don't, Steven Adams is coming hard. The vicious dunk.
Down low. Here's Favors.
And the dunk by Favors. Now, B.A., you know they would love for him to get more of those opportunities.
Well, that would cut into the deficit quickly if he does. Back to Conchar. The three ball. Memphis the rebound. Here's Clark. Soft touch off the glass. And the Grizzlies lead by eight.
You say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
Memphis has got 3 of 6 threes to fall in the third quarter. Anderson drives. Oh, and makes it with a kiss. Anderson's got 5.
The slow-mo has some remarkable handles. A point forward. He's got some nifty dribble moves.
Here's Gilgeous Alexander. Pass to Favors. Outside, Gilgeous Alexander. Goes back up. And the layup is up and in. Gilgeous Alexander's got 11 in the second half.
And his fantastic performance from the last game has carried over to tonight.
Yeah, the coach pretty smart for zoning in on him and giving him opportunities to stay with that confident play.
And as we end the third quarter, a great game. Both teams playing well. It's the Grizzlies. They lead by 8. All right, we're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of quarter number 4 next. Opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
You know, I'm kind of stoked that this was the choice because I love this pass. A remarkable find. He put his court vision on full display.
Well, a great job with the eyes. And what separates great playmakers, as we know, is peripheral vision.
Fourth quarter has arrived. So good to have you with us. And Oklahoma City looking at who they've got to start the fourth. We've got Lugans Dort. Alexei Pokuševski is out there with Darius Bazley. Then there's Derek Favors. And it's Williams in at the one. Here's Dort. Pass to Williams. Here's Pokuševski. And the layup is good off the glass.
Can't ask for a better look with the game in the balance.
The Grizzlies shooting at around 60% on this one. Very efficient. Out of bounds. It'll be Thunderbolt. The Thunder. Muscala, he's checked in for Favors. And Maladon subbed in for Pokuševski. Oklahoma City's gotten 5 of 11 threes to drop so far in this game. Pass to Muscala. Fourth quarter just getting started. 1 minute in the books. And they get it back. Here's Williams. It's wide right. Hits off the rim. Out of bounds. It'll go to the Thunder. Here's Dort. Inside. Here's Muscala. gets some space and buries the jumper.
Well, if you came here looking for a scoring battle, I think you made the right choice.
Both of these teams locked in on the offensive end. Going to be a high-scoring affair tonight.
About call. Memphis.
Watch Luke Dort play, and he's going to make it a nightmare for anybody that he's scored.
Court Brooks, he's checked in for Memphis. Gives us a chance to catch up with Allie LaForce.
Hey guys, I had a chance to find out what Taylor Jenkins was discussing with his players. He likes to be sick, but the offensive players are not far enough ahead to assume anything. Momentum can shift in a heartbeat. We have to be diligent, and we have to be smart.
And Allie, thank you for that. And with Dort, the numbers don't jump out. With friends, the eye test is easily passed.
Well, his footwork is remarkable. Lateral quickness, and with that wide frame, it's tough to get around him and that tenacity he plays with.
And the basket by Bane.
Absolutely ruthless. He's not about to start showing mercy now.
Confidence is sensational, and it feels like no one is going to stop him tonight from scoring.
Baisley, good.
He's force-feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
Memphis has gone 1-for-2 from deep in this fourth quarter. Pass to Jones. Fourth quarter play. We're about 2.5 minutes through it now. Hey, no good.
This has been a close game in a lot of ways, but they do have an edge on the boards.
Williams into the lane. And Williams punches it home.
Yeah, these teams are playing with incredible energy.
At least in the second half, they have been. The first half wasn't played anywhere near this intense.
Now here's Brooks. Pass to Jones. Three-pointer. Gets it. He's 6-for-10 and looking confident out there.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
They're pretty infectious right here, guys. In good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. Look at Dylan Brooks. What a contribution.
With the perimeter D struggling to stay connected to him, they're getting bombarded.
And now we present our New Balance player of the game, Dylan Brooks.
He has truly put on a show out there tonight, tearing it up on both ends of the floor. So impressive. And the other squad has looked helpless to stop him.
Through the fourth and final quarter here. Baisley. And that comes off the assist by Gilgeous Alexander. Baisley's got six here in the quarter.
Smart play call to get him something out of the rim.
Up at the three-point line and a fairly efficient shot attempt at that. Now catching the lead pass at full speed, terrific anticipation, and the delivery on time, on target.
For Oklahoma City, they've gotten 7 of 9 from the floor in this fourth. Here's Dort driving in. Oh, there's a killer two-hand slam.
I just love the aggressive finish.
Now I'm thinking he's sending a strong message with that jam. Fade into the lane.
Oklahoma City has gone 5 of 12.
12 from 3-point range tonight. Yeah! What a beautiful shot. Brings him within three.
Gildas Alexander is going to celebrate that one.
Pass to Brooks. There's 38 seconds left to play in the fourth, and they go to the intentional foul. And the Grizzlies with possession here. Their biggest lead of the game was 9, and the basket was seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Three-pointer Brooks. Connects again from distance. Buries his 10th triple of the game. Unbelievable, BA. Unbelievable. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They're behind by 7. There's 21 seconds left in the final quarter. All right, guys, what's your take?
Too little, too late. Making a change won't save them now.
Well, I'm going to use the cliche. You can't take your timeouts with you, so they're going to use it.
There's 21 seconds left in the game. And he sinks it. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5. And here's Memphis now. Here's Clark. Again, the Grizzlies. Good for 2 more. Gilgeous Alexander passes to Muscala. Williams from long range. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Here's Colbert. Goes up and lays it in. Nice and easy. And now a 9-point Grizzly lead.
Showing us that killer instinct right now. No letting the foot off the gas for them.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game. But once they broke through that barrier, it was all that complete control.
And so it's Memphis winning this one. This one was a fun one to watch. They were clearly in the driver's seat down the stretch.
They really were, BA. They played with great intensity on both ends of the floor, and they didn't allow their mistakes to get the better of them.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. So alongside Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, Brent Berry, and our entire 2K crew, I'm Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. We'll see you later.